the dawn of the 20th century. Ellis Island. Over a million new Americans passed through these gates. Most immigrants coming from the Russian Empire were Jews. They brought with them the traditions, religion, and culture of Eastern European Jewry. They passed these traditions on to their children and grandchildren, giving them the most precious kind of inheritance – knowledge of their roots. Our parents weren't part of this wave of immigration. If they were, we wouldn't have been born in Russia. We had a different fate to come to America a century later. Russia has changed markedly during this century, and so has Russian Jewry. We speak neither Yiddish nor Hebrew. We do not know Jewish traditions. Russian is our native tongue. In America, we are known as the Russians. As our children grow up, we lose touch with them. They do not understand Russian culture. To them, Russian language is alien. They feel ashamed for their parents' awkward English. Today's walk and rally for Israel were organized by Russian Jews. Parents and children working together. The children walked, chanting, "I love Israel." Children's words of love evoke sympathy and understanding in most people. But for some, the word Israel evokes different feelings. Russian Jews are especially grateful to Israel, because we, Jews from the former USSR, learned about anti-Semitism not from newspapers and movies, but from personal experiences. In the 60s and 70s, long before the collapse of the Iron Curtain, we were discriminated against in jobs and college admissions. The mere existence of the State of Israel gave us hope to persevere. Here we see a different kind of Jews. They demand the dismantling of the State of Israel. This is Naturich Kart sect. They dress like Orthodox Jews, and yet they are standing in a row next to Nazis and Palestinians. Had not Naturich Kart learned the historic lessons of the Holocaust? This is the scene we wish would never seen. Jews and Nazis united on the same side, together looking forward to a final solution to the State of Israel. And here is the Palestinian version of the same final solution. From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. They dream of a Palestinian Arab state on all of Israel's territory. Long live Intifada! What does Intifada mean for Israel? Sniper rifles, knives, suicide belts, bombs. Bombs like the one exploded inside of Bus 19 in Jerusalem. This bus continues to travel around the world, and its next stop is today in Boston, in Maryland. memory of 11 people killed. Elitz Vira, Jerusalem. Dana Itak, Jerusalem. Rose Bonet, Jerusalem. Anat Darom, Netanya. Yehetzkel Goldberg, Canada. Mebereki Filet, Ethiopia. Avraham Balakhsan, France. Baruch Kandiashvili, Georgia. Vairel Florescu, Romania. Natalia Gamril, Russia. Anya Bonder, Russia. They have been murdered just for being Jewish. Bus 19 continues to travel around the world. The terror cannot break the Jewish spirit. Every speaker at our rally praises the perseverance and courage of the Israeli people.
Уважаемые дамы и господа, ladies and gentlemen, on behalf of 750,000 Russian-speaking Jews in the United States, we want to welcome you and thank you for coming here. As somebody from New York, I'm so proud of every one of you coming here on a beautiful Sunday day to celebrate Israel. Because Israel needs us. We've created our organization, Russian American Jews for Israel, with a Boston chapter and chapters in other cities to support our country. We, the Russian Jews, have come to this country and we have made a great community.
I am honored and proud to be standing before you today as an Arab, to tell you about Israel, the only democratic country in the Middle East. Thank you. I'm going to give you a glimpse as an Arab into the heart and mind of the Arabic world that is capable to produce such savagery as Bus 19. So many times in history, people have stood by and done nothing, allowing evil to prevail. As America stood up against and defeated communism, this is the time to stand up against the terror of religious bigotry and intolerance. This is the time to stand by and defend the tiny state of Israel, the only democratic country in the Middle East, the front line of the war against terrorism, and it has been for the last 50 years.
From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free. For Russian Jews, this slogan evokes Hitler's call for total annihilation of the Jews and of everything Jewish. Jewish traditions, Jewish roots, and Jewish culture. Of the Jewish traditions that we didn't learn from our parents. Of the Jewish roots to which we, the Russian Jews, are only now beginning to reconnect. Of the Jewish culture that we hope to pass on to our children. Today we, the Russian Jews, joined with our children and grandchildren to demonstrate our support for Israel.